Welcome back. Hello, cupcakes. Welcome back to my channel. And if you're new, please hit the subscribe button. And for my newbies and my oldies, thumbs up my video. So this video is going to be a continuance of yesterday's video about my POF dates. So, and I'm going to be doing my makeup. Since it's Sunday and I haven't been out to the club I normally go to on Sundays, which is The Point here in Indianapolis. I love going to The Point. I got glitter on my face. I'm sorry. I do love going to The Point, but the job I was working at, I had to be up at 3 a.m. and be at work at 5 to 3:30. Tomorrow, I'm starting a new job, and my first day, I don't have to be there until 8:30. Of course, when you watch YouTube videos, if you're watching the makeup videos, you just pause it while you get yours together. You don't, you know, I don't know. Well, let's start with my makeup. I'm going to do my eyebrows first, and I'm going to fill them in and do all that good stuff that I didn't do yesterday. So about my dates, the first one, OMG. Okay, the first one I set at 1 o'clock with no kids. He was 31. He was fine and stuff in his profile, but he lost me when he just kept trying to tell me everything he had and shit. I'm like, nigga, why are you stunting? Nigga, why are you stunting? It's not that damn deep. And then I end up, I forgot that I told him we could meet at 1 o'clock or whatever. So really it was my fault, but then I realized he didn't even confirm it or whatever. He was talking about some 5 or 6 type shit. So I was already off his ass. So I'm gonna do it for my eyebrows. Now I'm just going to take Pro Concealer and Fawn and just do the top. So yeah, the first guy I was supposed to meet up, he was just too, those guys you could tell were, they make it seem like they have a lot of shit just to try to get you, but they really don't be hitting on shit. So I am glad I dodged that bully, because my mouth, my attitude, I just hate when men try to lie to me. Don't try to mind fuck me and don't lie to me and we'll be good. And then as far as the second date goes, okay, so yeah, my second date, we got there. Well, it wasn't gonna be a second date because I didn't cuss him out, but like I was real rude to him and mean to him. Because I had thought we were supposed to meet at 1 o'clock and I thought he was trying to game me or whatnot. So I was just rude. But then I had read in our messages or whatever that we wasn't even supposed to meet till 1:30 and he wasn't gonna be late or whatnot. So I'm like, damn girl, you tripping for no damn reason. So I inboxed him, I apologized, and I said, coffee's on me, you could cuss me out later. So he ended up turning around and meeting me there. Yeah, he turned around. We met there. My first impressions of him was like, okay, he's alright in person. Don't really tell because he had on some glasses. Seeing glasses. He said he needed on for at nighttime so he could see or whatever. Because I had asked him, could you take them off so I could just, you know, you look like without the glasses. And he was actually pretty damn cute. Yeah, he was cute. I was like, oh, okay. You look good or whatever. You look good. And I'm going to take Tay and just, you know. Okay, so now that my eyes are all ready for my color, did my eyebrows and stuff like that, I'm going to take this palette. This palette, I'm going to use this yellow. I never used this. I never used this palette before. I got it from when I was going to Chicochi University to be an esthetician. And they tap on a little bit about makeup. No, I did not learn how to do makeup there. Hell, the instructors there didn't even know how to do makeup. Everything I learned on my own. But yeah, so about the date, I don't know, man. He was really, really nice. He was cool. We end up sitting there for, I think, like a couple hours. And I'm like, oh my goodness, I need to be getting on out of here. This temptation is not... Maybe it's just buildable. Yes, buildable. So you gotta build it and steady, just sweeping it on there. This ain't what I meant when I said a gang bang. Takashi won the Minaj, I said Treyway. Curved him and went. It was awesome. Again, with me feeling weird because I'm sitting in this room, no music, no nothing, just talking to the camera. Like, I've met some interesting characters on POL. Like this one guy, he was so sweet and so nice, and like I can't say nothing bad about him. It's just like everything was nice and stuff. And then the only reason why I decided not to pursue him and kind of like let it dry out, because as a woman, I don't want to be with a man that has a bigger butt and bigger hips than me. I don't know if that's shallow. I'm not trying to be shallow. It was just like, it wasn't for me. Yeah, that's what it is. He wasn't for me. Not with them hips and that ass. He was not for me. Like, he was a good guy. Like, he was marriage material, shit like that. He had no kids. He had a good career. You know, he had it going on. But that ass and hips, honey, my ass and hips, I just couldn't do it. So now I'm going to use this palette from BH. And I'm just going to use this green. Because I told you I'm going for a colorful look. Now you take the green under the yellow and a little on top of the yellow. Just so you can bring it together. So it look like, you know. Now BH Cosmetics, the eyeshadow, like these palettes and stuff, they are very, very, very blendable and very pigmented. So if you're looking for some pigmented, blendable eyeshadow, BH Cosmetics, honey. Yes, it was my first palette. I remember, like, back in the day, well, I said back in the day, 10 years ago, maybe that is back in the day to some people. About 10 years ago, whenever I had got my first palette, everybody was getting that Coastal scent. But I just always stuck with the BH. I don't know. I'm glad I did. I never tried Coastal scent eyeshadows, let alone any of their products. I'm happy with BH. Okay, honey. Yes, boo. Yes. Yes. Yes, darling. Now we are going to do a highlight. I'm going to use just this color that I used yesterday in the palette that I got from BoxyCharm. And if you want, you can go back in with the yellow. If the green and your highlight is taken away from the yellow. like mine's is. So I'm just saying blend and brush and just go back in with the yellow. Yeah. Like that as such. It is cute. Yes, darling, yes. Before I cut my crease, I am going to use a highlight. So the highlight I want to go for today, I'm just going to take this angle brush. And I'm going to use Naked Cosmetic. I'm going to use this purple highlight right there. I'm going to put it under my brow bone. Told you ladies, going for a colorful look today. I don't know why I like color so much. I just do. Pop this right underneath the brow bone as such. Yes, baby, yes. And also in the eardrops.
Hey, ladies, have you ever had to call one of these little hood rats?
A NYX jumbo pencil.
And is she
pop
trying
it
to
on
like
the lower lid.
You don't know who the fuck your nigga is?
And also about my date. Like, we talked about everything, every freaking thing. And then it was like a nice conversation to have because it was like, okay, you talk, I talk, no interruptions. And we both just, I don't know. Just a real nice conversation. He's 30 years old. So same age as me. He has two kids. Two girls. I do like when men be having daughters. Because it seems like when they're good daddies, at least daughters do change them. Daughters change men. So already it's stuff that you don't have to worry about. Do this change numbers. Okay, now with your finger, I'm just going in and warming the color up on my lid. So everything can lay in place and lay smooth and nice. I'm going to use these pigments I got off of Amazon. Man, it's like so quiet. And if you have to stop, pause the video, make sure you do that. So I always go back. Now that we got our pink, let's go in with the orange. Now for the I mean, at least it wasn't a bad little meetup or whatever. I mean, it seemed cool. Damn, I think I'm losing my touch, y'all. I'm losing my touch.
Yeah.
So now we're going to apply liner. Of course, I'm using my Pretty Vulgar. I do like this liner because it don't bleed. Don't bleed. And then it has vitamin D. I don't suggest nobody do this. But I'm the type of person, I don't always take my makeup off at night. Sometimes I do sleep in my makeup. And when I do sleep in my makeup, I give myself a nice face shot. What's y'all dates been like on social media? Comment below and tell me about your social media dates. I'm gonna take makeup wipes and just clean up everything. I'm just doing this and not recording. It just don't take as much time. I feel like recording while you do makeup, it takes so much time. Cause you, I don't know. Not complaining though, cause I love it though. And I'm gonna take eyeliner and mascara. I love waterproof makeup because if your eyes water easily, then you have to invest in some waterproof Tarte liner, baby. Don't miss out your whole life. Maybe just some of your life. It gives you life. Now, of course, my Nazima. Gotta love this stuff here. And I like to take off all the extra in the middle off of my forehead. First is toner. I got two that I usually alternate between. Either the Active Moist or the soothing cream. Soothing cream is more oily, is more moisturizing than Active Moist. Active Moist is for an oil-free lotion. I love this Mary Kay brush because it cleans out so easily, and I didn't use nothing to help me clean this off with. And I'm noticing, it's just cleaning so damn easy. This is the first time I ever cleaned it like this, so I don't know. I always wash it with Dawn soap and put some baby oil, mix that together, and then that's how I clean my brushes. But since I'm in a little bomb right now making this video, I need it to get going. I just decided to wipe it off. And I like it. I like it like that. So I'm going to use L'Oreal Powder Press Foundation with my Mary Kay brush. I love this brush. Ladies, get you one. Get you a Mary Kay brush. The name, I'm listing it right now, right here. Order for me, baby. Order for me. And I just pat this on my skin as such. Y'all see that? And let me see. I like powder foundation for oily skin because it just leaves a nice oily free finish. If you have oily skin, sis, you might want to invest in some powder foundation. Now for today's concealer, we're going to use the Tarte. Since I have a bright eye, I do want that to be more noticeable. A lighter concealer than my MAC. And I'm using a dry beauty blender just to blend all this out. It's a little light. But with my Dermablend setting powder, I set that with that. You'll see. Yeah, that's a whole lot. That's why, I mean, you get your color, you don't have to do as much blending. But if it's light like this, sis, you're going to have to blend. And with this concealer, Tarte concealer, you don't need a lot. That's why I don't double dip, because you only need just that one. You have something this light, make sure you do not use a white. You don't bake with white. Bake with a neutral color. So it can at least calm down just a little bit. You don't gotta be looking all ghostly. You wanna make sure you get all the creases out before you put your setting powder on to bake. Well, be like that. I do know this tends to soak in your skin. I like it. I also notice if you cry or have watery eyes, it holds your makeup in place. And of course, clean up my lines. I'll just fix that one. And here on this channel, you know I like to bake for 5 minutes. Okay, now while that's baking, let's do our lips. So for lips, I'm going, since I'm doing a bright eye and stuff like that, I'm just going to do a natural lip. And I'm going to use NYX Liquid Lipstick. It's a new color and a brown pencil liner. Crayola. I love them. You see how pigmented that is? If you fuck up your line like me, just wipe it off, you'll be good. There was one point in time I was wearing this stuff like every single day. And I don't rub my lips because I don't want the brown to just submerge with the tan and disappear altogether. I just do that. So it'll look more like an ombre lip. Okay, so it's been like 4 minutes now. I'm just going to take it off now. But instead of just sweeping away, since it's only been like 4 minutes, I'm going to pack it in my skin also. Yes, baby. Giving me life. Setting powder will take away from your black eyeshadow or eyeliner. And I just go Okay, so I'm gonna go in over it. I'm gonna go back in with my L'Oreal pressed powder foundation. And, you know, just clean up the lines, make sure everything's everything. I don't know what it is. Makeup be having like your nose run and stuff. It does. Now I'm gonna go in with my Tarte setting spray. And that is it for this look. You always want to make sure you use a toner or a setting spray after you get done using setting powder, because even though you baked and you wiped it all off or whatever, it still may leave like a key look. So the setting powder or spray, whatever kind of spray you use, will help it to look more moisturized, instead of just a dry powder, if you get what I'm saying. So again, if you like this look, please give my video a thumbs up. Chatting with me, though I couldn't hear you. I know you had some things to say. I said in my other video, as long as it's not rude or disrespectful, of course you're allowed to leave the comments down below. And thanks, ladies and gents, with my cupcakes, for taking the time out your busy life just to watch me. Bye bye.